So, we filled up with gas. We are 60K from Princeton, which is Eric Larson's hometown.
Yeah, Eric.
Al got a samosa.
It's not bad.
I'm driving now.
Pretty good.
And we're back on the road to Nelson.
On the road to Nelson. So we're in Osoyoos now.
Cam's favorite place.
Yep. It's kind of dead here though. We, how much further we got left on our trip for today?
300 kilometers. A mountain road. 900K today. Leaving us 3,100 to go.
She messaged me earlier too.
You're excited? Why? What happened?
Oh, that was a little fly.
That was a spider.
You're like, you're very dead.
Hello?
Hello?
Hey, how are you doing?
Good.
Good.
Oh, shit. Just hung up.
So where is that?
We're in Osoyoos. Osoyoos. And so it took us about five or six hours.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. To get here. And we still got about 5 hours to go.
Hey, babe.
Yeah.
Well, I'm really impressed because by the sounds of it this morning, I didn't know if you guys are going to make it out of town.
I know. We were cutting it very close.
Well, I'm glad to hear you're on the road and safe and sound and all that kind of good stuff.
Yeah, I'm glad I was able to catch you here at the subway parking lot. That's good. Very convenient.
Yahoo for unsecured...
unsecured internet. Yeah.
Well, that's great. You guys drive safely.
We will.
Okay.
Do our best.
I guess. Drive recklessly, I suppose, then.
Cautiously reckless.
Well, it's quite exciting. Day one.
Yes, day one. Day one.
Yep.
It's nice. I guess. Damn, that car smells good right now. yeah. So, we're slowly making our way. Now I'm starting to think it might have been easier to fly.
Yeah, but it wouldn't have looked as cool.
No, that's on me. We're in Nelson.
We're gonna go see Cole. He's probably coming. I'm sick and this is bullshit.
So what happened this morning?
The van didn't start. I don't know. It won't start. I don't know why.
What's the solution?
Cole's dad's gonna save us. Again.
Again.
Papa Jones.
Yeah. Look at that. See that small town thing just coming back full circle.
Yeah, small town Timmins in Nelson.
Yeah. Coming all back around.
Feels good.
Full circle. Feels
good.
You want a war, and you want
Hey! How's it going?
Actually, one, just like old times, let's go and boost Adam!
Yeah.
Yeah. It wouldn't be right if we didn't, I suppose.
You gotta listen to your car, you know? It's telling you something. Don't go east. Don't go east.
Oh, everything. Everything in the last, like, month has been like...
Don't go east.
It's like, there are forces of nature being like, you're stupid. I'm trying to warn you.
We're just about to leave Nelson, BC. Just had a good visit with Cole. Had a brief little hiccup with the car, battery dying, but Cole's dad graciously came and saved us.
Again. Thank you, Mr. Jones. Yeah, so hopefully it was because I left a light on, and the battery's not screwed, but...
Here we go. On the road again.
On the road again, over some treacherous mountain pass.
Yeah. Till next time.
We are, that lens is very, very dirty, on Kootenai Pass, which is one of the highest roads, I guess, in North America, at 5,800 feet above sea level. The vehicle's still running because I'm afraid to turn it off, because this morning it wouldn't start, and we're not completely sure why. And it's day two of this trip on the long road home. I don't want to really leave BC.
Alright, so we're in Cranbrook. We're just getting the battery checked out, and it's dying, so pop it. Yeah. Hopefully all is well.
Yeah, 13.31, so it's not doing too bad.
Yeah?
Really? You know how you tell? You disconnect that battery right now,
yeah,
and the car dies, your alternator's dead.
Yeah?
If the car keeps running, your alternator's fine.
That's an old school test that we always do.
If you disconnect that, the alternator should run the entire vehicle. It's designed to run the whole car. But if you take it off and the thing dies, that means your alternator's not working, period. It's like a 2-second test.
Yeah.
So it's a waste of buying a battery for nothing, right?
So the consensus is that we need a new battery.
What it is that your battery's fucked.
Apparently these batteries are kind of expensive, which sucks.
Rick helped us out. Thanks, Rick.
All right, so hopefully in T-minus whatever minutes it takes us to get this thing on, we'll be out of here.
Ordinary people don't care about art. The song is also a direct response to the cutting of arts funding in their home province. Here's Library Voices.
Rachel, wake up.
Alright, so we made it to Invermere. We're gonna head up to the hill, meet up with Courtney, and then head down, back down into town, hit up the butts, get some wings, and enjoy ourselves.
Hi, Courtney.
Rachel, wake up. Someday you'll grow up and fall in love. With some clear-eyed boy who's strong to the top. His honey starts to buzz about how he's working every night. Tending on double shifts. And you'll figure... He spreads himself to you.